Hi and welcome to getyourrestaurant.com, where we teach you how to open your own restaurant and be successful at it. This is Gopal Kamath. You can see my photo over here with 32 pieces of teeth or tooth, whatever they call it, smiling. And you're most welcome to my humble channel, YouTube channel or Facebook video, wherever you're seeing this video. I'll be teaching you in depth on how to open your own restaurant, how to do various things which make sure that, help you to earn a massive amount of wealth, at the same time satisfy as many customers as possible. My goal in the coming 10 years is to create a minimum of 10 lakh restaurant owners and help them to achieve their dreams of living a successful life. So this is Gopal Kamath again, and let's move forward. Today we have a very exciting topic which I want to cover with you, and which is one of the reasons why 99% of the restaurants fail, and that is all about how to price your menu. So I'm not sure why this thing is not moving. Yeah, cool. So this is the pricing strategy. What should be your pricing and why should you be so successful, if at all, you know, you're focusing on the right things. The main thing which you need to do is to price your restaurant menu nicely. So the tagline is how to successfully price your food to get maximum customers, earn more profits while making sure they come back again and again. This is a very key component of earning continuous profits, is that your customers should, or your guests in the hospitality industry, what they say, should be to make sure that they come back again and again. So if you sell your customers food just for the one time and they don't return, then you're not going to make the amount of profits which you're going to make, because there are going to be no sales. So make sure you keep that in mind, that your pricing has to be so perfect that it should be in the range where the customers eat, they feel they happy about the quality, they feel that you have priced it and it is worth it, the value which they are getting. So that means you are not overpricing it, and that will make sure make them come to your property again and again. So before we go further, I would like to ask you a question. Did you get my book? So if you don't know, I've written a book called Restaurant Secrets. The tagline is how to open a successful restaurant fast, even if you don't have any experience. So if you have not got the book, I urge you to go to my website, www.getyourrestaurant.com. Go check out the book, and if you like it, just go for it and buy it. It's a very good small read where I have written step by step in layman's terms how to open a restaurant and what all you need to know in order to open a restaurant. It's a very basically cheaply priced book, so anybody and everybody with a intention to open a restaurant can get it. Don't waste your time, go to the website and just go and get the book. Now we'll move further. Before before talking about pricing, I have done an in-depth video on menu pricing, with the restaurant menu pricing. You can go in this channel and check out the videos. The video is called The Winning Formula for Generating Massive Profits from Your Restaurant Business. So I have given in-depth strategies there in that video on how to open, how to price your menu, what all should be the items, what should be. So this is the winning formula which I have mentioned in the which I have shown in that video, and you can go and get it there. It talks about what all the big restaurant chains are doing, how they are making a profit. So if you talk about any burger chains or pizza chains, they are selling their entry version at a very cheap price. So why they are doing that, how they upsell, how they make profits, and what is their overall strategy. It is mentioned in this video. Just go to the videos section of this channel and find out the winning formula. A video named The Winning Formula to Generate Massive Profit from Your Restaurant Business. You'll get an idea. In fact, I have even given a link to download this winning formula, so you can go in the description section and check out the download link there. Now let's move ahead. The things to remember when you are pricing your menu, these are the four or five things which I am going to mention now. The first one is, never sell your food cheap. So this is one of the biggest mistakes which a restaurant owner does. What he generally feels is that, you know, if I sell my food cheap, a lot of people will come, I will sell a lot of food and I will make profits on the volume. This is one of the biggest mistake, and it is very easy to think about this strategy because it's the most human nature. Everybody of us wants to save price. So when we are selling something, we always think that if the customer wants to save price, he will obviously, if I sell it cheap, he will come to me and he'll have my food, and then he will I'll earn a lot from selling it to more number of people. Unfortunately, it doesn't happen that way because everybody sings the same thing. Everybody wants to sell cheap. There is a price war going on in the market, and the truth is totally, totally different than this principle. So never sell your food cheap. I'll tell you why people, what people think, frankly speaking. Now, if you are selling a food, let's say, for example, you are selling patata vada, which is the, in Marathi we call it that batata vada, and pav, vada pav cheap. The person who is, the person who really wants to have, will think that if the food is so cheap, if the food is so cheap, he must not be using good quality of materials. I might, get a food infection or a food poisoning or something like that. So let's not eat there, because then you don't remember one thing, he's getting those food items. If he is taking a parcel, he's getting it for his kids also, for his family also. So unless you are in a place where there are a lot of people, the floating population is too high, and the pricing, the affordability of your customers is low, I would suggest you to do this. But don't be the cheapest in the lot. You don't have to be the cheapest in the lot. You can give good quality and you can charge a little higher rate. Profitability should be your number one factor as far as running your restaurant is concerned. Second point is, never overprice your menu. Whenever you are overpricing your menu, what happens is the customers who are having your food, the guests who are having your food, they'll come, they'll have the food once, and once they taste the quality, they will feel that they have been ripped off, they have been looted, or they have been, they have been pickpocketed, or they have been, you have charged them a lot. That gives a very, very bad experience to your customers, and your customers will never return again. So make sure that you are in the middle of that pyramid, where you don't charge too less and you don't charge too high, you charge a reasonable amount. And even if you charge a reasonable amount, you give good quantity of food. So think about this. The best thing, you might ask that how you'll know whether I'm charging less or whether I'm charging more. The best thing to do is to take a feedback from your customers. Give them a feedback form with a comment section in which they can put the pricing details, and customers will literally tell you. They will tell you, boss, you have charged. Now, I'll tell you what. I recently went to a restaurant with my family and my brother-in-law and all, and it was a restaurant was serving seafood, and they charged. We ordered for a portion of in Marathi they call it a tisra masala. So tisra is like basically mussels, or if you call them mussels rather. So that portion was charged around $650. We literally thought that we were being ripped off, because that one plate of tisra masala was charged as $650. I'll not name the restaurant. It's very unjust for me to name the restaurant, because I don't want to spoil their name. But I felt, being a hotelier also, I felt cheated that tisra or the mussels, which we get in the market for 50 rupees or 100 rupees. Even if you add another, the same amount for cooking, the same amount for material, the pricing should not go beyond $300, and they have charged me more than double of that, $650. So that felt pretty ripped off. They didn't have a feedback from, so we didn't write the feedback there. But ideally that owner should have kept a feedback from, so that people write and they tell you what is wrong with it, and you can then adjust it accordingly. Because ultimately you're doing all these things for your customers, you're not doing it for yourself. You can have anything in your house, but if you're charging a customer, it should be reasonable, so that the customer can come back again, the customer can have your food again, and they can keep buying from you, and you're making a little bit of profit, but at the same time every day you make those profits. So that is the second thing. The third thing, sorry, the feedback form is being covered. Fourth is, price your food on the top and the bottom level. So now, as I mentioned in this attractor formula, you should have a entry level item also, as well as you should have items which are little bit on the higher side also. So let's say for example you have some items which are meant for the masses, but at the same time you should have a item like a platter or a special item which are charged little higher, so that people who can afford them can actually order them and have it and feel good about themselves. Because if you know, there are two categories of people. There are categories of people who will always opt for the higher item no matter what. So you have to give them an opportunity to order that from you and make sure that that takes care of your profit levels. Now, fifth is always focus on selling bulk orders or high cost items. So this is one of the biggest points which most of the hoteliers never get. I don't know why. They are always focused on selling food to single items or walk-ins and all. They never focus on bulk orders. If your restaurant is located in a city or in any other kind of mass populated area, you got to get orders which are bulk in nature. Like for example, if your restaurant is nearby some offices or societies, they have some functions, they have some parties or things where you can always order them in bulk. Bulk order is always it gives you a multiplier effect, because you get to get a big bill. Let's say for example your average ticket size is 1,000-2,000 bucks, but in a bulk order you might get around 30,000 or 40,000 rupees. So that increases your profitability, because your fixed costs are the same, and at the same time it's a huge peak of revenue for you. So this should happen at least a few times in a month, so that you get those cash flow insurges whenever required. And the sixth one and the most important is always keep a tight control over your expenses. If you don't focus on your expenses, focus on your expenses, there are chances that you will lose this game. Because don't go haywire if once your revenue starts increasing. You have to control your expenses, then only your profit margins will go up. If you start spending like crazy personally or professionally, your boat will rock and you will have to shut down your restaurant. Please don't take this the wrong way. I am being a teacher over here. I have done this. I have lost money by getting off the eye on my game, and that's one of the reasons why I am focusing on this. So these are the six things which you need to focus, apart from this video, which you can always go and check. This will make once you go through all this, it will be clear what you should focus on while pricing your restaurant. Now comes the last. Thank you so much. This concluding this video, let me first tell you, I hope you like the video. If you like it, subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon and share this video with your friends. Comment on this video. I'd like to read your comments, and I always reply to your comments if I feel that the questions or the comments are worthwhile. My next video is coming up, which is about the 9 most important steps to create a dream restaurant. So this will give you a step-by-step roadmap of what you need to know in order to open your own restaurant. Thank you so much for watching this video. This is Gopal Kamath signing off. Bye-bye. Take care.